But, you know, if you ask them all to do like step by step up, and you train them very hard, like you can get like 78% on a data set that was especially designed to not be solvable by GPT-3. So there are signs of success. There is something that creates a knowledge library in Minecraft of these trees of thought. So I think we're moving to a world where these thoughts of the models, they become the foundation of learning. I mean, parameters are still important, but the tokens that come around them become what the models need, what is important. They may be grouped into libraries, they may be retrieved from the retrieval. So
the model has like no space to, I mean, it needs to do this thinking inside its layers, and that doesn't, that may not be enough time and space to do. So what you can do instead is, instead of immediately giving the answer, you can give a model an example of how would you think about it, so that every step of the thinking is much simpler than just giving the answer. So here you'd say Roger started with 5 balls, 2 cans of 3 balls. So there is 6 10x balls in the cans, and he had 5, so together he had 11. And then the next time the model starts doing this, it will also think before answering. So this is the very powerful idea that you're not saying, model, answer me. Give me the first token, second token, third token, and you need to do everything in your layers. But you can say, well, Do the things in tokens. Like, tell me what you're thinking, and only then give the answer. And if you do that, there is a recent paper that says the model can basically do any computation. It can even execute programs. It's Turing complete. And does this really help? So on mathematics, you can see that you can tell the model, hey, do this thinking, but do it like number each step, like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, as you see here, and be very precise about each step. And then you can try to verify each of these steps of thinking separately. You can even ask the model, well, was step 3 correct? Was step 4 correct? And when you do that, like this MATH dataset, which is a little bit tougher math problems than like the pure arithmetic, this was a dataset where GPT-2 could do nothing. It was especially made to show like what the models cannot do. If you add this thinking, you can get to like almost 80% just by allowing the model. And it's not just mathematics that where you can build this thinking. So there is one paper of how GPT-4 can play Minecraft, and you can tell it to build libraries of functions of code. So as it wants to do something like get an axe, or it needs to do something in the game, it creates a code that is a routine that does something, and the next time it needs to do it, it can use this function it has created before. So not only do you have some thinking, you can access the thinking you did before, and here this is through using code.